Today on 2. What a wonderful holiday morning to start off the day.
Yes, it's been a great weekend. Weather's been perfect, and so we're very excited to be here on Memorial Day.
Yep. Wonderful day of barbecue, relaxation, and observation.
And observation, that's right. Yep. We have a tendency to forget what Memorial Day is all about, and we're actually going to feature something about that today.
Yes, we are. George has an interview lined up. He's going to be recording he has already recorded. I can't even speak today. See, this is what happens with Mondays off.
That's right.
Because I can't speak more than usual.
Right, right. Okay, but anyway, we've got a great guest lined up that George has done an interview with this gentleman and a former Korean War veteran, and just a great interview. Yeah. And so we're very proud to be able to present that to you today.
Well, if you haven't been outside yet today, let's tell you what the weather is going to be like for today. Our weather is brought to you by Mitch Chevrolet, located on Cherokee Avenue. Make the switch to Mitch. Let's take a look at our weather almanac for the 27th of May. The average high, 85 degrees. The average low is 58. The record high, 92 degrees in 1941. And the average low is 40 degrees. The record low is 40 degrees set in 1961. Tonight, the sunset will be at 7:51. And tomorrow, sunrise at 5:58. Let's take a look at our forecast for today. Partly sunny, just a 20% chance of showers and thunderstorms with a high near 82. Tonight, partly cloudy with a low around 62. And tomorrow, mostly cloudy with a high near 84. So hopefully that 20% chance of rain will just precipitate. We won't even have any kind of...
Or maybe you can barbecue or grill in between showers.
With an umbrella.
If it comes that way.
So
it comes
that way.
Yeah. Hopefully it won't do that, but you never know, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I guess we have a Facebook friend we'd like to acknowledge.
Well, let's take a look. No Facebook friend for today.
No Facebook friend for today? Okay.
We'll save it for tomorrow and see who we have.
Good deal. They're sleeping in today, huh?
They are. Facebook shut down for Memorial Day.
Okay. I gotcha.
It didn't really.
Okay.
Don't freak out.
Yeah, don't panic. Oh, well. All right. So, got any big plans for today?
Actually, I'm going to rest a little bit and find some barbecue. That is on the agenda.
Oh, you got to find some barbecue.
Got to find some barbecue out there. Who I'm going to find it from, but I'm going to find some barbecue.
Very good. Very good. Well, I might do some of that myself today.
Do you have any plans, like on the lake or anything?
No, nothing really major.
Really?
No, just we've been taking care of my grandson this weekend, which is always fun. And so we'll be able to, I think, get him back to Nashville today and get that done. So anyway, yeah.
We'll
go meet his mother halfway and kind of do that sort of thing, I guess.
Trade off.
Yeah. Just on the interstate. Here he is. Here, it's car signal. Just take him.
Just roll down the window and flip
on
the
house.
That works.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. I guess. Not really. We don't do that. I promise we don't do that.
Well, we hope that you have great plans for today.
Yep.
Have some relaxation planned out. Yeah. And we hope that you enjoy the rest of the show. We are going to take a break and come back with our merch and ads. And we'll be right back after these words.
Okay.
Premier Bank, we're very proud of the long-lasting relationships we have with our customers. We'll go almost anywhere to meet your banking needs.
overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Coleman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Newton. Call us today and let us tailor our loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
Meet the KitchenAid 36-inch induction cooktop. It might just change the way you cook. Induction technology heats the pan and not the cooking surface to offer you a new level of precision, speed, and energy efficiency. 9 settings give you different levels of heat to achieve precise temperatures and amazing responsiveness. Water boils in just seconds, making this the fastest to boil induction cooktop available. The KitchenAid 36-inch induction cooktop.
Life lived in black and white is not a life lived. Today, I choose color. To see it. To feel it. To be in it. To be upon it. And to live a life surrounded by it. Today, I put on a fresh coat.
Although we do not have prizes to give away today, we do want to pay attention to the ask, because we will ask a question tomorrow. Yep. And we'll have a load of prizes tomorrow.
Right. There's some great prizes lately, and some good winners.
So
pay attention.
We will start with our merchant ads. And remember, just pay attention, because we won't ask a question, but we'll ask it tomorrow. We're going to start with Brown & Company Beverages. They're a beer cave with barware and specialty items. Go check out the great deals on Highway 157 Northwest in Coleman. That's Brown Company of Beverages.
And Mr. Hicks Menswear, of course, he is offering suits made to your measurements. He has the businessman's regular sizes, big and tall, those hard-to-fit guys. Go to Mr. Hicks Menswear.
And the H. Chance Christian Bookstore has the MyEbo Color Tablet. Song downloads, ebooks, audiobooks, Bibles, video games, also Bible software, and more. They're located in the South Coleman Shopping Center if you're looking for a Christian tablet.
And Tires for Less is more than just tires. They do feature Bridgestone and Firestone tires, but they can do a whole lot more for you to get those oils changed there. Minor engine repair, shocks and brakes check. Go see Greg and the guys.
And the Dr. Comfort Diabetic Shoes are now available at Borden Family Pharmacy. They're located on the corner of Eva Road and Highway 157. It's the finest quality diabetic footwear, period.
And Uniform Place, featuring the Allegria shoes in the latest fashions, the Blue Bubbles and the Midnight Garden. And they also have Landau and Med Couture and a whole lot of uniforms at the Uniform Place.
And Move Over for Emergency Vehicles is the reminder from Earl's Body Shop, where they also have large and small towing available, local and long distance. This is Earl's Body Shop, Highway 31 North in Coleman.
And Menards Gallery and Gifts, where they feature framing products, but of course they can sell you some jewelry and sell you prints and let you just look around. It's a great little art gallery, and it's a great place to just go and browse.
And Make Waves to get your boat ready for summertime with this Sony Marine Stereo System that's on sale for $149. It includes AM, FM radio, a CD remote control,
and much more. Deb's Bookstore is your hometown bookstore just down the road. Browsers are always welcome. Gift certificates are available for those hard-to-buy-for people.
And Knight Free Insurance Agency is one of the top 10 growth agencies in the state of Alabama. You can visit them on the web at knightfreeinsurance.com or in person in First Avenue Southeast.
And there's Deb's Bookstore again. Of course, she has used books at half price off every day. New books are 20% off every day. Located at 207 3rd Street Southwest in Coleman.
And come spend your summer with us. If you're looking for an outdoor pool to go play in today, the Coleman Parks and Recreation wants to remind you that their outdoor pools are open at the Coleman and the Wellness and Aquatic Center from 10 to 6.
And Dr. Howard Rogers, of course, is the guy you need to see at Baldwin Counseling Center. If you're having problems, you need to talk, you want some privacy, he can help you with a whole group of things.
And foreign and domestic repair and service is available at AutoTech. Go see David Methman for all of your foreign and domestic needs. They have a new location in Fayette beside the Ridgecrest Community Church.
Okay, now it's my turn. The Choco Peanut Butter Brownie. Did I say that right? Choco chunks and brownie pieces and creamy vanilla salt syrup. Even comes in a cake or a blizzard.
And Mullins Body Shop, you can count on today as well as 50 years ago. They have auto body repair and towing. You go call Stacy Sunny. Stacy Tracy, Beth, or Jim at Mullins Body Shop.
Knight Free Insurance, providing insurance coverage for over three generations. One of the top 10 growth agencies in the state of Alabama for auto owners.
That's a look at our merchandise for today. Remember, we will ask a question tomorrow. Who knows what it's going to be about? I don't.
Who knows?
I won't be here.
No.
I'll be off.
Okay.
All right. Well, we don't have any birthdays for today, but we know that there's someone out there celebrating. If you have a birthday, just send us an email, or you can call us here at the station to let us know. All right, we are going to take a break, but when we come back, we are going to visit, or George has an interview prepared for us, Norman Hale.
Yes.
And he is a veteran, served many years ago, and he is going to tell us some stories and kind of his experience, I think.
And I think he was a POW.
Yep.
Yeah. So he's got some very interesting stories. I know George is very excited about presenting this, and so how appropriate for Memorial Day.
Yep.
And our salute to all the veterans out there and to all the soldiers and everybody that are serving across the United States and across the world, trying to help keep us and our borders secure.
Absolutely.
We appreciate
and
that.
Those families that are having to
exactly
live
right.
out memories
exactly
as
right.
well. All right. Well, we hope you're having a great holiday today, and we will be right back after these words.
There's stuff around your house, but we don't make stuff. We make ovens. Dual fuel, double ovens. And they bake so evenly that now delicious is something you can depend on. We only make things for one room. The best room. Your kitchen. We're devoted to it. And you can feel it in everything we make. Nobody knows the kitchen like KitchenAid.
Overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Newton. Call us today and let us tailor our loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
At Premier Bank, we take pride in serving our community. We respect our customers, and we've won awards for our ethical conduct. We're motivated to do all we can for you, and we're interested in your banking needs. We're efficient, safe, and sound, and our relationships with our customers are second to none.
At Premier Bank, we put the customer first.
Bank, we're a bit old-fashioned. We actually answer the telephone when you call. However, old-fashioned doesn't mean we aren't up to date. With the latest technology, Premier Bank meets the various needs of our customers. Mobile smartphone banking, internet banking, ATMs, convenient offices. At Premier Bank, we have the right products right now with good old-fashioned customer service. At Premier Bank, we put the customer first.
Red White Jewelry, it's a family-owned business, and we can service all your jewelry needs. We have a knowledgeable and friendly staff. And if there's something that you need that we do not carry the line of, we have a close networking with other jewelry stores also, and if they carry a line that we do not carry, rest assured we'll be able to get that piece for you. So when you think of Red White Jewelry, that's really all you need to think about. Shop Red White Jewelry for the good stuff.
We heard that the war was almost over when we got there. But then the Chinese got around behind us, and there was 250,000 of them people got around us and surrounded us down in a little place called Kunlea. And there was no way out. We went straight up a mountain. And I stayed away from them for 3 days and night. Well, we went up on this tall mountain. It took you several minutes to get on top, and it was steep. And we stayed up there, and then the next day, we was getting so hungry, the trucks were down at the bottom, and they had food on them, crackers and stuff like that, and we were hungry. And when we started down, one man and me stayed up on the hill, and when the others got down there, they came out from under the ground down there where they had a little cone shaft up in the mountain.
Talking about the North Korean?
North Korean, and started shooting with and killing the American people. So they hollered and said, go back up on top. So we went back up on top. And that's why we stayed. We tried to get off the other side, and we wound up right in the Chinese headquarters that was at night, and we crawled back up on top. This broke out all at one time when the leaders of our company, they said, get out the best way you can. And just turned it over to us to get out, because they didn't know how. They didn't know it was coming, and we didn't know the people were coming. We didn't know the Chinese were coming in. And it was a surprise to all the commanders and all that. It was a surprise to them. So due to that, we were on our own. When the Chinese, we was hid in some bushes up there, and a whole line of Chinese came up the hill. And when they got by, I told other fellas to tie their rifles down and throw them one part one way and one the other way, so they couldn't get a hold of them. And then we tried to get off of the other side of the mountain where we'd had the battle the night before. When we got off the other side of the mountain, there was a whole squadron of Chinese. I was looking down a 50 caliber machine gun, and I told the boys we were in trouble. And they came up and put us in foxholes separately. The foxholes were way over our head, and we sat there all day till dark. That day, all day. And then they took us to a med check that night. And after that night, they said they was going to feed us. And we were real hungry. One morning they parched some corn in a wash pot and gave us a handful of it and told us to put it in their pocket. We were going on a march. And we started on the death march towards where we camped 5-4. I spent the rest of my time in there. They said, the further we went, we'd have to stop off on the death march because the weather got so cold and the snow got so deep. It got down to 50 below zero.
What were you wearing? What you had on, I guess, huh?
Just what we had on, and I had a power liner that was under a coat, and that power liner and a scarf, all I had. I'd lost my cap and everything, and I tied it around my ears and things. A lot of them began to hurt that couldn't walk. It was too weak to walk. And when they would fall out, they'd say, we're going to put them in an ox cart or something like that. And we'd hear a shot. And they'd come up through the ranks. Don't fall out, they just shot another. And then when we got to Camp 5, as in Pyeongtaek, Korea, we got there and we started marching December the 1st after I was captured. On the 29th of November, and we marched till February of the next year, because on account of the weather, having to stop off, and many, many men lost their limbs, toes, and I was boiling up cracked corn one day out there in that cold weather, and a boy came out and washed his feet, and his toe come off in his hand, and he cried. He didn't care. You lost your pride when you got in that shape. And after we'd been there 2 or 3 months, the Korean said, either shoot him or turn him loose. That's how they were. So we can't afford to feed him. So Russia told China, said, you school him and we'll help feed him. So we got a little more crack corn, and we got high gear.
What's high gear?
High gear is, they raise it here in America for cattle. It's got a little blue seed on the top of it, purple looking seed. And you can see it along with, was about waist high, and we had to boil that up. It'd take you all day to boil it. And a lot of people asked us, didn't we eat rice? Rice was a treat. Only certain days of the year we even got any rice at all. It was cracked corn, high gear, and some old turnips. Well, when those people over there can make it sound so good. You've heard stories here in America that sound so good, but it ain't true. You visualize what they're trying to say, and they can make it sound good, like socialism, communism. They can make it sound good. Because they said nobody will go hungry, nobody will do this. But we've seen the Korean people starving to death. And we learned from seeing the Korean dying that they were lying to us. So when you go into communism and socialism, you're going to suffer. There'll be, I don't care what they say in the United States, it's going to be bad. We'd have to go to a lecture hall that we helped build out of mud. And it, on the pictures it looks like a resort thing, but it's out of mud. And we whitewashed it white. It'd take us to that lecture and sit there for 2 and 2.5 hours each session. And one, we had a dog to come into the camp one time, and people give him some of that cracked corn, that high gear, and got him fat because he was skin and bone. And we went to a lecture one day, and a boy that had played with him a lot saw him hanging up, and the Koreans had him there and skinned him. They was going to eat him. They already had him clean. And that boy started to jump at him, and they put a band net into his hip, and it went to the bone, and they made him sit in the lecture till for almost 2 hours till they got through with the lecture. And those lectures were telling you how bad America was and how good communists was and how good you would be treated if you turned to communism. And it's by seeing the other people, how they were treated, that taught us that communism wasn't the right way to go. Well, when a person died, one died on my legs, and I put him outside and put him in his clothing and drug him across the ice. And they were dying at that time, about 40 a night. And so we drove there, and they wouldn't, the old crude picks that they had to dig with wouldn't go through the ice but 1 foot deep, 3 foot wide and 6 foot long. And you dug that, and I dug it by myself. And you just rolled them in their clothing and then put them in there and covered them over with the rest of ice. And you couldn't get it no deeper. The only reason that we made it is through prayer by the praying people. The reason I said this, my mother was a prayer warrior, my brother was a prayer warrior, my dad was a prayer warrior. But they asked for prayer for me everywhere that they went. And my dad was a minister, and they sang together. So everywhere they went, they asked for prayer, and prayer was answered. First year we lost between 1,600 and 1,800 men that first winter in my camp, just Camp 5. That's all I can speak for right now. I wrote a poem, and we don't know what his name is, but he wrote the 1,600. 1,600 had died, and then two more. Somebody said there's more than 200, but I said close to 200 more died. Yes, there was 1,600. Not a bugle was heard, nor a funeral beat, or even over a drum sounding retreat. As over the ice, the corpse were carried to the hill where the GIs are buried, 6 foot by 2 foot by 1 foot deep, on a Korean hillside they sleep. Young and old are wondering why 1,600 had to die. No little white cross with their name, but they are not buried in shame, although they lie in an unknown grave, 1,600 American braves. No useless casket enclose their breast, GI clothing for their last rest. All color of men, black, brown, and white, 1,600 faded lights. A pill, a powder, medicine of any kind, or should we say a stronger mind, could have saved them from yonder hill, 1,600 laying still. In their illness, tossing and turning, most of them knew there would be no return. Some went easy, some with pain, 1,600 died in vain. When we go home to enjoy a feel, there they are still on that lonely hill, forgotten by some, remembered by most, 1,600 in their last post. Author unknown. And they part some corn in a wash pot and gave us a handful of it and told us put it in their pocket. We were going on a march. And we started on the death march towards where we, Camp 5-4, I spent the rest of my time in there. They said, the further we went, we'd have to stop off on the death march because the weather got so cold and the snow got so deep. It got down to 50 below zero.
At Doug Doggett Jewelers.
In the nation, our agents are always there, helping make sure that when your life changes, your nationwide insurance coverage changes too. We put members first because we don't have shareholders. Join the nation where protection is personal.
Nationwide is on your side.